Learning Torah in Israel is different than learning Torah anywhere else, because in Israel, we're living in the exact place where the things we're learning about occurred.
Like, anywhere you go, like, you just feel inspired. Like, you learn the real text, and then you, like, look outside your window and you can see it.
One of the best parts of learning about the history of Israel is being able to go to the sites and walk their footsteps.
Really, there's nowhere like Eretz Yisrael when it comes to Limud, and that Hashem gives us the special koach of Limud in Eretz Yisrael.
Learning in Israel this year has been one of the best experiences of my life. It's so amazing because you're learning with all these guys and all these rabbis that are helping you grow so much.
Well, learning in Israel, the Vilna Gaon says that there's no better thing that you could do than learn in Israel. And you really feel Hashem's fire and power and presence when you're learning in Israel.
In Yeshiva, it's like 24/7. You're in a great environment. You're surrounded by people who want to learn just as much as you, and you're pushing yourself. You're really giving it 100%.
The Shabbat experience in Israel is absolutely amazing. You can either go to your Rebbeim's houses, to your family, or stay in Yeshiva. And in all three of those places, you get to experience Shabbat in a way you never have before.
The Shabbat experience in Israel is nothing like nothing else in the world. We're just all there together, all like the boys, and we're just chilling and like Devar Torahs and great food.
Shabbosim in Israel is uncomparable to the Shabbosim in the States. With the atmosphere in the streets, religious or not, people are singing and dancing, which is what really shows you what Shabbat's all about.
Shabbos in Israel is unreal. Whether you're in your Shiva and you have all your Rebbeim or your new friends around you, you guys all have a sick time together, or you go out to other cities with your newer friends. You go to Sfat, you go to Tveri, you go to Yerushalayim.
One thing I really enjoyed was going to the Kotel for Friday night, seeing hundreds and hundreds of people davening the same way that you daven, and seeing the same exact things that you say, but like all together, just incredible, powerful thing to see.
It's really a great experience to just explore other communities and like experience all the best things in Israel.
A couple of weeks ago, my yeshiva and I had the opportunity to spend Shabbat in Sfat, and it was incredibly inspiring to be in a place with so much history and in a place where everyone was so uplifted.
We miss our bus, and it's like 12:30, and it starts snowing, and we got stuck in Jerusalem. And so I was like, yo, you know what, like, we're in Jerusalem, might as well just go to the Kotel. So I go there, and I bump into one of my YULA boys, Akiva, and me and him, we go daven Marv at the Kotel. And we see like a bunch of guys who are like just singing there, and we just start singing there, and it was like for hours while it was snowing.
Being able to go daven at the Kotel is very inspirational to me. To see so many different types of Jews pouring their hearts out to Hashem is a crazy sight to see.
I went with a group of guys to ruins of what historians say is probably the third oldest shul ever to have been built, and we daven mincha there, carrying on this thousands of years long Mesorah.
This grave called a Mukah of Rav Yonasan ben Uziel. And it was a crazy segula, they said, for shidduchim. And everyone was like packed up, the entire yeshiva was packed up in this really small room, and in this beautiful gravesite. And we were all praying our hearts out for anyone that we knew they needed to shidduch. And we were singing our hearts out. It was amazing.
Regarding my morning shiur, Rabbi took our entire shiur on Tanis Esther to visit the Kevers of the Gedolim.
A couple of yeshiva guys, we decided that we're gonna go down to the Kotel and learn nicer there. It was just like a glass half full view of making the most. Like, it was crazy. There was no one there, yet we were pushing ourselves.
My Emunah in Hashem is different in Israel because I get to be in the exact place where all the Nisim we learn about and all the Torah we learn about happened there, and it's incredible to learn Torah through that lens.
Everywhere you go, like, you see stuff like 50 times older than anything you've seen in LA. Like, it just, like, it's miraculous to see like the stuff that you actually learn and then it actually be there in real life.
I would say my Emunah towards Hashem has grown significantly this year. The connection you have to God here is something you've never felt before. Whether it's wearing a kippah or learning in the base, you'll always feel a closer connection to Hashem. I highly recommend taking a gap year in yeshiva after high school.
Seeing the entire country just stop for Shabbos and knowing that there is truly one God in Hashem, this is our state and this is our people, and it's just very, very inspiring, and it helps me have a lot of faith in Hashem.
I really think that yeshiva just cements your emunah. It makes you, it's not necessarily something that your parents believe, it's something that and that you're just following it and you believe in too, but it's really something that you yourself is. You're independent in your emunah.
You realize that everything you do has a purpose, everything Hashem does for you is for the good, and you can't get that anywhere else, and I can't describe to you how, except for that you're just going to have to come and see it.